Hello everyone, welcome back to the Darkest Dungeon. Looks like we have a lot of people who are in a perfect position to go and fight this goddamn prophet. What do you reckon? They didn't want to. Obviously we leveled up at least a couple of people in the last episode. Are there people whose quirks are going to cause a big issue? Well, let's look at the people we were thinking of taking. What we want to do with the prophet is have enough damage to hit the back, but also we want to be able to knock down the pews, because if we manage to take the pews with us at the end of it, we get those few extra coins. We get a lot of gold for it, which is pretty good, because it turns out that the prophet has been one of the most difficult bosses for us so far, which means, like, in the last episode I think I was talking about one of the things you can do is take a take a cultist and use the weakening curse, which we obviously don't have unlocked here. Minus 30% damage, so it's quite likely that stacks three times and therefore basically does 90% less damage as long as they all take. And then the other thing you do is take a DPS heavy troop along with it, because it doesn't then matter if they're having the rocks dropped on their head, because it's not going to hurt that much. But also we want to be able to try and beat up the pews whilst also taking down the prophet. But of course, if we take anybody who has to hit the back, for example, any of our Hellions, who are all apparently level 5, so that's not going to work. If we were to do that, then as soon as the prophet moved forward with the destruction of the pews, we'd be in trouble. I'm thinking, I really want to take Erasmus and Raikuda and Pete. We can also take Megistos, and now I'm thinking Megistos because we can always have one person doing some tanking by using the protection, the guard ally that we have here, Defender, which would mean that if somebody was stood underneath one of the places that the rocks were going to fall, we just use this skill here, get them underneath, use it on the one that is going to land on, and it lands on Megistos instead, and he takes at least some of the hits there. The alternative is that we take people. I mean, we've tried with Brian and Psycho, and we tried to beat the crap out of the front two pews to bring it forwards. It didn't really work, but what we didn't do is take someone like Pete. If we took Pete in a sort of a DPS and cursing capacity, we could also take someone like Holmesy. We could also take Imzum here, who has a great opportunity to hit everything with Hans Harry. It does do bleed, and that's basically going to miss out on everything, but it is an option. So I'm thinking that what I've been doing basically is over-specking for the boss, but now I'm sort of overthinking instead, which is just as bad. We definitely want to take Pete. I'm really going to try and go for this using the weakening curse thing. But maybe we do a mission to level up these other people first. How does that sound? And what we can do, in fact, is take four people, including Sir Gyrus, get a load of money for the next episode, in which we will then try the ruins, provided they don't all go completely doolally as a result of doing what we're about to do. What are we about to do? Good question. We need sort of a level 3, medium level 3, stave off sickness. We could take... Yeah, we could do that, because Holmesy and Erasmus both have a disease, and Erasmus can, of course, remove a disease. We'll be in the Weald, which is reasonably difficult, but not hugely difficult. We'll take... So let's say we take Holmesy, Erasmus, and Raikuda. That's two moving around type units, but as long as Erasmus goes first, it should be okay. If we did something like this, Erasmus moves to the front. Bear with me. Raikuda is then in this position. Raikuda moves forwards, Erasmus in this... Okay, so then those two can dance around, which means the person in this position has to be able to work in these two positions. And we haven't taken Penelope Puddles for a while. Oh, I did say we'd actually take Sir Gyrus. And if Sir Gyrus... Yeah, Sir Gyrus doesn't really work in that position, this position, but they do work in this position and the back. So maybe we can sort of start off with Sir Gyrus here. And then they'll immediately be in that position. So you've got a disease as well, vampiric spirits. Maybe we don't worry too much about Holmesy's rabies, which is not a sentence I often consider myself likely to be saying, but they... Oh, another quick draw, John. It's likely to be saying, but there you go. Now, taking a... taking a antiquarian at a low level on a longish... A medium, obviously. Longish mission, where you have to gather stuff, seems like it's a bit of trouble, actually. So maybe we should look at this one. It's the same setup, it's the same thing, but it's going to be done quickly. We don't have to fill up our inventory with stuff, and we are not going to be in the dungeon such a long time that our inventory fills up anyway. So maybe we look at trying to upgrade these people. We do want to take Holmesy, Erasmus, Rykuda, and Pete, I think, or Holmesy, Erasmus, Magistos, and Pete. At the very least. Yeah, that seems like a good one. On the boss mission. Right, so we probably should look at upgrading Holmesy and Erasmus before we look at upgrading anybody else. So we will do that. Now, Holmesy. I will upgrade the important ones, which is Divine Grace and Divine Comfort. Mostly Holmesy will be in a healing capacity, because Holmesy is a healer. Erasmus... Honestly, poison darts could really do a lot of damage against that boss. So maybe we start... Maybe we invest in that. Pick to the face can't hit it. Lunge can... Lunge will move you, but it does damage against a thing which is not the boss, which may not be the greatest thing in the world. But Thrown Dagger does hit the back. Damage versus marked. Does this unit have a mark on an enemy? No, but does this mark? No, one of these does. Yeah, here we go, Vulnerability Hex. We could sort of combine Vulnerability Hex and Weakening Curse on Pete here, and thereby have a mark for Erasmus's use and the Weakening Curse for us not dying use on the same unit. Now, trying to keep them both up at the same time might not work, and I might just not bother with the mark after all of that, but maybe we just upgrade Thrown Dagger rather than Poison Darts. 4 points around. See, it's only 4 points around for three rounds, and it doesn't do that much damage. So maybe we upgrade this. So that's going to be our boss-killing set of things. Yeah. And then, well, let's see if we can invest in Pete and Magistos here. We do need to unlock this, at the very least. Ooh, it actually does minus 32% damage. So, if I keep buying for this... That's very interesting. That could completely negate all its damage, or at least if it does resist one, we still have a decent amount of damage removed, which is great. But we won't spend all that money just yet. And Magistos... Mostly you're going to be doing guarding and then hitting stuff. So that's fine. Yeah, good. Let's sort out our embarkation, which is where we do the trinkets. We bring them all back because it's quite likely that other people have the ones we want. Rykuda, you are going to have damage range. Seems good. More stress damage, more crit. Sure, you can have some ranged damage with less stun resist is fine. Maybe we want to just give you straight up eldritch damage, really. Which is one of these. Hello? Where's my eldritch fighting? Oh, they're all down here, of course. Eldritch. You can have that. Unless I want Erasmus to have that. I think I kind of want Erasmus to have that. No. Have this. Take that. There we go. Erasmus is going to have this and this. So on a very early thing, Erasmus can try and do as much crit damage as possible to something that's quite likely to be Eldritch. We'll take human just because you get human stuff everywhere, I guess. You are going to take books. The scouting chance could be nice. The less party surprise is definitely nice. Maybe I just give you a dodge thing. Something that makes you less likely to be hit in general. You're going to be at the front. Oh, no, you're going to be at the front. Okay. We don't have a tank here, so we're going to have to get through this nice and quickly, although it is fairly DPS heavy, so I think we're okay with it. Maybe more heals received. Yeah, that could work. And then you are just going to be amazing at your job. Where are you? Here we are. The more heal skills there. And do we not have a chalice? I thought we had a chalice of healing. I mean, this is fine, but maybe that's somebody else's playthrough. I am confusing myself and other people. That's fine too. We should get some levels here. I'm hoping I'm remembering how to play this game properly. We'll take a couple of these. At least bring one from Erasmus, which is nice. It's short. I think I won't take too much stuff. On the off chance that we will find some stuff. Bit risky, but I'm going to go for it. Now, there is a chance that we come back from this so stressed that we can't take this party on the next mission. In that case, I'm quite happy to put them in for a proper amount of stress relief in the hamlet. When we get back, spend some of the money that we're bound to get now on doing that. Also, don't let me forget to use the gyrus to do all this stuff. We probably want some... I'm tempted to not really take anything else. Let's fill this back up. Let's not completely ruin it. Right. Don't need to do anything else. We'll embark. Now, thralls will explode if left for too long. We did discover that, although we discovered that left for too long was one round. Or two rounds. It wasn't really, you know, we didn't have much opportunity to get rid of said thrall, as far as I recall. Never mind. At some point in the future... I didn't even realise you were this stressed. That was completely my mistake, but never mind. We just have to hope that you don't stress out entirely. I mean, we're not really using this unit except to, yeah, good start.
Another mariner, another miss.
We're not using this unit except to interact with stuff. So, their combat glittering effectiveness gold, is really only all that's going to be affected by anything, any flip out, basically, any affliction. It's basically going to affect their combat effectiveness, but their combat effectiveness is usually just run away anyway, so that's fine. We are here for stuff, so we might as well do the curios and the battle with treasure. I'm kind of expecting... I'm expecting to have some trouble here, so... I'm not completely confident about this run. We do have a good healer, of course. Ooh. In a torch. Obviously. We do have a good healer, but we don't have a good sort of defender. Which I'm... Yeah, that's exactly what I was expecting to see on the first machine round. We'll lunge at this then. Hopefully this won't completely lacerate one of our weaker units. You resisted the move, that was good. Thank you for doing so. Now. You can shadow fade. Yes, I actually do want to advance here. We'll activate a riposte. And kind of we're going to be hoping that this thing attacks Rakuda, basically. Move? Yeah, that's fine. I'm actually quite happy with that. That basically puts us in the original situation. Probably, now I think about it, should have brought some bandages. I guess we just nervously stab this. We have to kill this. Despite the fact it's got a ridiculous amount of protection and HP, it has to die. So, maybe we can stun it? No, we don't have the stun. Okay. 6 to 8 on everybody. On someone seems like a good idea. That was 14, so maybe I should have done Divine Comfort. Fine. We'll learn. This could be a horrible, horrible fight because... Oh, that's how it's going to be, is it? Very well. Open vein. Do you bleed? Not very well. And it gives us 3 points around. It's not very good, is it? Can we knock this back? Move 70%. Possibly. Yes. Back 2 somehow. Let's de-accuracy it. That seems like a good idea. Not a fan of this at all. Forward 2. We can still lunge at this, which is good. It is too wide. That's how that works. We're all out of order, though, which is a big problem. Ah, it's going to be a big problem as well. Erasmus, no! We have to do this. There's no two ways about it. Please stop stacking up 16 damage per round on one unit. That makes me sad. Definitely should have brought some bandages, but I was looking at it going, what's the worst that could happen, right? Yeah. Guess what the worst that could happen is? That's when you fucking die on the first round because of this jackass over here. Fuck. That's a lot. Lunge, kill it. Where's my crit? Erasmus, you have one job. And you dodged the odds. You resisted! You're amazing. Yes. Please stay alive. Please heal for more than the damage that it's doing so that we don't immediately lose Erasmus in the first round, if that's entirely possible. I don't even know. And why is this not helping, huh? What's this damage going to be? 2 to 3. Please. These things are the worst! I hate them so much. Oh, might have to just run away. This is not good at all. No, don't kill Sejaris on the first round. Oh, great.
On the brink, facing the abyss.
Yusuf, naturally. Look, I will accept the responsibility for starting off at 80% here. I completely neglected to notice that. I am not going to deal with this bullshit, though, for fuck's sake. What is even happening here? Can we pick to the face this for enough damage? Where are my crits, Erasmus? I brought you for the crits. I'm out. Let's try this again. Leave. Unmatched. Leave. But in failing to recognize it. I'm glad that Wayne is on my side with this retreat. This happens a lot, you know. It's not about, once again, you know, losing. It's not about making that mistake. The real problem is in thinking you've not made a mistake, you know, and going ahead with it anyway. Everybody survived, and that's what's important. All idle heroes, 33% stress heals. That's pretty nice. One good week. And while the campaign continues to drag on, recent events have emboldened the standing roster. Confidence was reported to be an all-time high. So me retreating has put everybody at an all-time high. Of confidence. Not just at all-time high. Right, so it wasn't very good. Now everybody's got this 40% shit going on, which is a bit of a problem. Which means that Rakuda and... I really wanted to upgrade Erasmus and Holmesy. Holmesy doesn't necessarily need it, but Erasmus is as powerful as Erasmus is going to get. Maybe I need to upgrade this here. Yeah, probably. It could be worth bringing Erasmus on a mission just to make it worth putting Erasmus into stress relief? Well, we could just stress relief anyway. It's expensive, but what will you only... Will not pray or flagellate, so you can drink. Please don't disappear as a result of this. I don't really want to do this because it's very inefficient. Quite true. But also, I would very much like these people to be available, basically. This is expensive as fuck. I hate you. Let's do a very, very difficult high-level mission. Ready? Let's get rid of you and you. Go away. What is this? Kill the swine god. That doesn't sound very nice. Look at this, though. I mean, we could do a boss mission at the champion level. These will be level 5 people doing a level 5 mission, which is probably worse than level 3 people doing a level 3 mission, for sure. Or we could try and do one of these. A short champion mission. The Cove. I don't want that to... I hate the Cove. It can go away. Although, Ancestor's Pen. More crit melee, more damage melee. I mean, that could help us out with the boss fight. Here in the ruins. And there's this one, the Wield. Ancestor's Mustache Cream. Blight resist, debuff resist, more stress damage. I mean, I suppose if you look dapper enough, that would make some sense. I think we're not ready for a level 5 boss with level 5 people. So we either do this one or this one. And I don't honestly know what sort of creatures we're going to encounter in either of these, but we can take Miri if we wanted to. Not that we've upgraded any of these people. I mean, I would expect to see that, in fact, most of these people are still quite far behind. We haven't even upgraded the guild to allow us to upgrade these people, so this is going to take quite some time. So look, Tim. Oh, we can upgrade these people, but not for very cheap. I'll probably take this Hellion. It's Tim here. Let's do a DPS-ish mission. Let's try and do a short champion mission, because that means we're out faster, right? We get all the benefit from it. Wow. I'm just looking over at the waveform of my voice just now, and I don't feel like I spoke any louder, but it's clipped. It's clipped quite considerably. So we'll take Zeke. Zeke has fours. D has fours. I guess it doesn't matter. Three and four there. Three and three there. So D actually has a little bit more armor. You see, it's a level four armor, so that should keep her alive a bit longer. Three and three. This is bad. Like, these are so low. We need to get money somehow, but how? Without just braving these missions. That's not good. That's no good at all. Maybe we don't take me. Tim, you're up. Perfect. Fours. Outrage. Let's do a double Hellion mission? How does that sound? What have you got? So we'll turn off Iron Swan, because you won't be in that position. You can yowp. Can't do that. I'd like to unlock one of these then, wouldn't I? If you switch places. I mean, this is probably a terrible, terrible idea, but I'm sort of doing it. So, whatever. You ain't the boss of me. Marie, Jekri, do you want to come with? Jekri, you can come. Sweet. Ooh, that's a named group. Eldritch Angels. Interesting. Or female, maybe? I mean, the characters, not the named people. I don't know. I don't know. This seems terrible, but we have got a pretty decent healer. We can go and use our trinkets to improve that as well. Let's get all these back. Hellions. This is why I kept two of everything, if you recall. Bleed skill chance. Who's using bleed? You both are? Sweet. So you both get a bleed pendant. Less stress damage doesn't seem that useful, although it probably could turn out to be. Less stress damage and more accuracy. That's probably good for the Iron Swan one. So you can have that, and also this. And then you might as well have this. More crit torch below 725. Well, that's no fucking good, although we do have this. You might as well have something actually useful, like... Like what? Yeah, like what? Exactly. Another bleed skill chance? I mean, we could really go to town on the if it bleeds using that. Yeah, we might as well. Go to town on Tim with the bleeds and then Doug here with just straight up damage. And the accuracy is really good for Iron Swan here. Oh, turn that back on. Kind of prefer that. We do have if it... let's do that. Now you can use... You're very much a frontline unit, but whatever. Trinkets, please. This one. This one and this one. Jekri. More damage, more speed. More disease resist, not that useful. Stun skill is probably useful. Do you have it? Yes. And I guess something that improves your... Yeah, blight, bleed, and debuff. Oh no, that's resistances. I want the opposite of that. If I can have the opposite of that, please. I wonder if we have such a thing. Blight skill chance? Blight skill. There we go. Well, this is a short mission, so we will provision for a short mission. I have no idea how well this is going to go. I'll definitely take some bandages because I am scared. Although, don't forget, Jekri can heal bleeds. We should probably take a bleed healer. Whenever we go into the cove, to be honest. We'll take a stack of each. But we'll take a couple of keys, because this is the ruins that we're going to. Provided we survive at all. And I'm half expecting people to die, but if people die, at least we can make use of that space in our roster. I'm scared, but let's go. I'm very scared. I mean, I have had some trouble in the ruins in recent memory, as you will probably recall, just at level 3.
Face out the halls of your scouting is nice. Once familiar. Now,
what are we doing? 90% of rooms. That's a very awkward shape for 90% of rooms, if you don't mind me saying, but there you go. At least there's no battle in this direction. Check where I'm going to make you look at this. A map. Thank you for looking at that. Well, it's told us where all the curios are, which is interesting. Very well. It doesn't tell us what they are, of course. But at least there's no fight in here. If we get a scouting in here, that'd be super useful. We didn't. I guess we try this one because we... Oh! Why did that happen? I'm very interested to know how I know about this battle. And I'm wondering whether I should avoid it. I'm not going to avoid it. That would be cowardice. Right. I am a coward. Run away! Coward! How do we start this? Probably with ones that don't debuff us. Like those. So we start with an iron swan, I suppose. We kind of need to kill that first. So maybe we just wicked hack the shit out of it. 5 to 10 damage. All of these are very weak. Have very low damage indeed. HP indeed. Yeah, let's get rid of the ones that will go away first. Uh-oh. Is that a move, is it? It is a move, but we resisted both of the effects of it, so that's fine. Also move. So these things try and move a lot. Move us a lot. I think at this stage we try and put a plague grenade on these. It's spreading out damage, but it's spreading out a lot of damage, and that makes me happy. At some point I may wish that I had... That's fine. Let's try to stun that, but at this stage I am not that bothered. We can also cure our own blights and bleeds with this unit, so that's also pretty good. If it bleeds on this, might be a good idea. I'm a bit leery about spreading all this damage around these two, but putting damage over time on them, plus the fact we've got all these bleed skills, the chance of this not catching seems pretty low. And in this case, maybe we just try and stun something. Ready for next round. Yeah, I mean, maybe this 12. That was probably the right thing to do, considering it didn't actually top us up entirely. But I admit that I was not entirely sure about it. If you want to keep resisting that move, I will be super pleased. Resisting the stun, a bit worse. But this is actually doing... This is 8 damage around on this thing. Some stress on D is fine. I mean, oh, that's not fine. But okay. Good dodge. Thank you. So two of our units are completely out of action. But I'm actually... wondering whether I can rely on Jekri to do a large amount of our damage here. This thing is dead, so we don't need to worry about that. We might as well... What's this? 10. Plus, that's 13 damage on that. This will stun two of them, potentially. Very high stun resist, so maybe not that. And that will bleed out that, so basically I want to wicked hack this. Try and bring it down into death range ASAP. You know, this... 13 damage this round, 13 damage next round. Still only 26. It does have some damage yet to go. It's getting its one go, so... What a dodge. That wasn't as effective as you thought it might have been, was it, mate? Don't forget our torch going down whenever that thing seems to do stuff, which is a bastard, but okay. 5 to 10 is basically guaranteed to kill that. So I'm quite happy with that. And then we will... I guess just Noxious Blast this. What's it on? 14. Yeah. Jekri's Plague, and by extension Marie's Plague, is going to be really useful for us in the future. Because it gets around a lot of things, and 5 damage around doesn't necessarily seem like that much. Until you realise that you're going to have a few rounds, and once it's stacked up to 10 or even 15 damage a round, these things are dead. These things are absolutely dead. Like, that thing is not going to survive one more round. We resisted all the effects of that, except for the damn... Excuse me? Okay. Well, they're both dead now. Call me a liar. Whatever.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them.
So apparently the bleed came off before I suspected it. Oh, now you crit. You crit when it had 1 HP left. Holy shit, though.
As victories mount, so too.
I think that was a fine fight, but I do not like the fact that that was the first fight. Kind of just sort of hoping that things continue that way. Jet Crew's been really good here. Apparently you're touching that. Well, a buff. 20% damage until camp. I mean, I was fairly sure that that was a thing it was okay to poke. Ah, good. No more combat. But I was kind of hoping to sort of choose who. Honestly, I'm glad that it was one of the Hellions that did that. I'm not sure what the options are for that thing. I think one of them might have been just quite a lot of de-stress. Yeah, sure. If Jekri had used that, I don't think it would have affected their damage, because their damage would have been mostly blight damage. We're not using any melee damage, and I don't think it would affect that. Maybe it would. It would be one more damage per round, which could have made a big difference. Rune battle with treasure is where we're going. No preferable unit to
finding the stuff is only
interact with
test.
That with, so now this is great though. Look at all that home. Money. There's a trap.
Curious is
I knew there was a trap, but I was bedazzled by riches.
By his own
I was looking at my amazing collections. These... We've seen these before. So unless they are... I mean, they're literally the same units. That was a good dodge. I'm kind of wishing you had breakthrough right now. None of you do. Maybe we try and stun these two? I mean, it debuffs us to some considerable extent, but we can get rid of that if we wanted to with the things we didn't buy. Good job, well done. Jekri, do something useful. Just like that. Don't dodge the fucking plague grenade. That's no good. You can't be having that. This is going to be a bit more of a difficult fight, I'm fairly sure. As you might imagine. Yeah, you move. Can move forward one. Can you not move backwards? I feel like I should check that. Well, that's all you can do. A crit on that, though. Very useful indeed. Check, we do this again, and don't miss. Okay, good. I'd like to Iron Swan that, but it's got such good dodge. An Iron Swan is already inaccurate, even though we've buffed it slightly. There's enough of a chance that Iron Swan will miss, that maybe I should not have done the... plus this, you know, less damage and less dodge here as well. Oh, yeah. Well, it's not that bad, I guess. Yeah. Could have told you that was going to happen. These two are basically interchangeable, though, so as long as we can get back before everybody dies... Gonna actually have to focus on Jekri a bit here, because that was a lot of damage just now. As long as we can get back into position before they continually force us into the wrong position over and over again. Yeah, shush. I mean, at least this unit is dead, right? It's done all the damage it's ever gonna do. This one is not, and that upsets me. I mean, we could sort of try and disorientate it. Or we disorientate this one. Yeah, that did work. This one's had a go. Ouch. And this one hasn't, so I want this one to not have a go. That seems to make some sense. Please hit. Good. Now it's dead. That's exactly what I wanted to see. If it bleeds, doesn't hit that. So we will move you forward one again and get everybody back into position. And D does have another go, so we can at least get Jekri away from the dangerous part. And Jekri can heal themselves if we deem it necessary, but 3 damage for 5 rounds is probably necessary, I'm going to have to say. That's a lot of damage. That's 15 damage, and Chances are it won't last long enough. The combat won't last long enough to allow us to use that at a later point. So I feel like it's a good idea to do that now. What's your bleed resist? 65. You're gonna... Oh, I still can't hit it. What am I doing? Fine then. You've got one round left on this. Guess we could try and stun both of these again. It still has its resistance, but this one doesn't. We've got them both, which is really, really good. I was not prepared for that one. I was prepared for that one not to be stunned, but the fact that it did get stunned means we now start killing the shit out of it. Beat it up. Beat me up, Scotty. Give everyone a bit of healing. 7 is good. I don't like this. We got rid of the things that were the most issue, but look how much stress Jack was taking as a result. It's just a disgusting amount. I think I misread this combat when we moved into it, though. I'm wondering if maybe we should just sort of not have so much stress going on. If we bleed out this, what does it give us? 4 points for 3 rounds. It will do some damage to it. Or maybe we just... let's try and kill this one because I'm tired of it, to be fair. Hey, it will die, but it will get another go. Which is not something I'm looking forward to. That was fine. Okay. As the fiend falls, okay. That's what we like to see. Who's worse off? Jekri proportionally and literally. I mean, maybe not proportionally? I don't know. But I will probably give it to Jekri because Jekri nearly died recently. Whereas Doug here has, you know, not, basically. So we seem to be out of the woods at least on this fight, but obviously this is a level 5 dungeon and it is quite difficult. So here you go, you can have some damage. It does do actual damage itself, so there is that. If it bleeds, can't do anything as we've seen. That heals us 4 HP, but it doesn't get rid of the debuff. So I think we just tank our own debuff there. We now bleed out this one. Holy shit! How long have you been able to do that? Cool. This is a lot of cash. Even if we abandon this quest, this is a lot of cash. Because we are filling up our laden with loot, are often low on supplies. Thank you, Wayne. Exactly what I was thinking. We are filling up our pack. We've got one obstacle here. How many shovels? We've got 3 shovels. It's fine though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we're going to have to do at least one of these 2 rooms. I'm not looking forward to it. I think I will only do one of them because there are 2 battles on each room, right? And we'll get some loot for doing them for Shizzle, but I don't think that really makes up for it. They're surprised. Go to fucking town. Seriously. Did you see how much damage that thing did, by the way? 10 to 18? 11 to 21. I mean, we could kill this. And this is going to... Like, we don't want Jekri to flip out if we're going to possibly avoid it. So maybe we... Oh! Annihilated. Oh! I don't know what to say. That was just absolutely perfect. Okay. I'm honestly tempted to try and disorientate this because we're unlikely to kill it. If we can stun it, yeah, perfect. If we can stun it and still do damage to it, which... It doesn't bleed. 245%. How much damage does it do straight up, though? It's 6 to 12. We can't wicked hack it, which is really annoying. Which incidentally does not enough for either of these. I think I will simply, if it bleeds this, because it does a lot of damage, a significant amount of damage, or misses completely, which is also an option. Like, stun something else? Yeah. Absolutely brilliant round. We got rid of the thing that I was most afraid of, which is the thing that can do stress damage to everybody quite a lot. And if Jekri becomes anything other than cooperative in the next 20%. Oh yeah, perfect. Brilliant. Well done. There's no way of reducing this except for camping, by the way. Which I suppose is on purpose, but also I don't really like. Thank you. think we have to try and get rid of this, even though it's less than efficient. There's a strong chance that Jekri's about to go do Lally, so... Please hit it. Thank you. Is that dead? Three. Yes, that's dead. So, if we can avoid Jekri going Doolally by not doing any more stress ever to Jekri, perfect. I'm not sure how much we can guarantee that, but I'd like to try. Big crit there, but D hasn't had it. Oh, there we go. Good thing. Careful. I suppose that means that Jekri will avoid attacking in some situations. That wasn't even half of the crit that we just took against us. Not in this situation, apparently, so I'm happy with that. We'll do this. This one's dead anyway. This one is now one round away from death. This gets one go. Or we could avoid it by stunning them both. That one didn't stun. That's fine. This one is now dead. That didn't hurt too much. This one is now also... Wow, good. Pretty much basically dead anyway. Stun comes off, dead next round. We now do this again, and please crit. No crit. But 12, consistent 12s, I think I'm happy with. As long as we don't take too many more crits like the one we just did. I think we should be okay. Let's just put a Noxious Blast on it, maybe? Does 2 damage and gives us 5... on it, which is not perfect. That's a bit stabby. Can you stop doing it? I would like to get... D will have a go. Rest this advantage. So that's fine. Give them no quarter. And heal yourself. It does buff you, which I do forget. Maybe we should look at doing that a bit more often. Unfortunately, Tim here has not yet had either Blight or Bleed on them, so we haven't had the opportunity to use that in anger. Please just die. Have a shitload of damage. Maybe that wasn't the best thing to do, but okay. I'm thinking with the amount of D-Bleed skills we have. We don't actually need these bandages. I'd rather take... Do I want the busts or the citrine? I think I'd rather take the busts because many things are currently gated by our ability to upgrade the hamlet. Jekri, why don't you read these books since you're already... Balanced. Sorry. What? More move resist. Replace Warrior of Light. I like how it doesn't tell you what the thing it replaced was. It tells you what it was called, doesn't tell you what it did. We have come into here with low torch, which is not ideal. Right, let's not make this mistake again. Kill this. Why is this thing always one damage away from death? Whenever I do this, it's always one extra turn before it fucking dies. It's because it's a shit. Can I kill it?
Yes, you can.
No. Do that. Buff thyself. Brilliant. Well, it gets a go. Whatever. It's dead on the next turn. And I'm fairly confident that it's dead on the next turn, rather than it being nearly dead and then the thingy runs out just before it's dead. It's definitely dead. That was a good dodge, by the way. I appreciate that. That was a bad slice. I was going to do a divine... comfort, but I'm thinking maybe we just heal D. No, we'll keep this up. D's not taken too many hits recently, so maybe on the next turn if we deem it necessary. Yeah, stress out Jekri. Jekri's already over the edge.
Great is the perfect weapon that cuts on its own.
Right, Jekri, continue to do this. I'm going to ignore the torch at this stage. As long as it's above... I think it's 75? I'm not sure if it has to be at 75 or above 75. What is happening? Stop that. And you can't even heal yourself, which is really annoying. And Jekri's had their go. Good grief. And I just used all my bandages. Oh, perfect though. Alright, I meant to look at this. Torch above 75, so we probably should use a torch. Just to make sure that that works.
The light, the promise of safety.
Less stress damage, more accuracy. The accuracy is the main important thing there. If it bleeds this, which does bleed, 12 damage as well. Oh yeah, you're dead. Screw you. Please make sure Doug doesn't actually die. 10 is not brilliant, but it's only 3. Yay! We got a free round. I think we bleed out this. Does debuff us, but you've resisted that bleed, you fucking dick. Now do this. The HP is not important, but then you cured. Oh, cured of the bleed, I think. What? I was relying on that to some extent. Although we did get to go first then, so there's a chance we get to go first again. Keep Doug alive at your own expense, unfortunately. Get this thing closer to death if you can. If it goes first. This thing has had great luck, I'll be honest. Way more great luck than I'm happy with. What have we got here? Less damage, less dodge. Do it again. Don't resist. Thank you. The fact that that resisted a bleed and then a blight, even though both of those were buffed. To be fair, not that buffed. Only 30%. That's a big buff. Shut the hell up. What are you talking about? It's an amazing buff. Just, cure yourself there. I might have to do this again. Oh! He shoots his skulls. Back of the net. Come on, New England. Something, something, something. No one watches football anymore. Bleed out could actually do enough damage on its own, is what I'm thinking here. Wow, we're doing way less damage on our own. 6 to 10. It's our most damaging attack, even though it's a bleed attack. Yeah. And then we can Noxious Blast it, maybe? We'll just hit it again. I don't know. Do this. Probably should have healed yourself for more than that, but at least everyone's, like, fairly well off right now. Probably should have listened to that, really. Don't really mind. Sure. No resisting. Great. I don't think we can do anything here except kill it, so kill it we will. Famous last words, right? 14. Only a little bit of overkill. Ooh.
Success so clearly in view.
We get to keep quite a lot.
Trick of the light.
I'm going to get rid of crests because they're a dime a dozen. Plus, we can sell this if we don't actually need it, and I'm pretty sure we don't actually need it. Purge evil and restore purity. Increase resistances on a hero. Right, so we're going to go back this way. Just basically to reduce the amount of combat we have to do in order to complete the mission. The combat has been going fine so far. Don't let me even try to suggest that we have been doing badly. This is a level 5 mission with a newly level 5 party. And yet, here we are in this... Okay, it's a torch. Here we are in this strange situation where we're not completely eating shit. Which surprises me, considering the fact that I once fucked up a trap. Are you kidding me? You're all shit at traps? Well, there's that. This is one of them double Hellion runs that people have spoken about.
The cold stone seems bent on,
and it's going really well. Having the two Hellions have different abilities obviously makes some sense, because Hellion abilities are frontline sort of things. Right, one combat left in the whole of the dungeon makes me quite happy. This seems trivial compared to what we've had to deal with so far, although they are going first. They're at least attacking Jekri with the stress. Although, if Jekri gets any more stress, Jekri's having a fucking heart attack. Pass. Stop it. Yowp. It has to be yowp. They both resisted, which is fair. I mean, previously they both got hit, and they do have a reasonable amount of resistance to that. Please do something to this. Because Jekri did not get the opportunity to, because Jekri chickened out, which is understandable in their situation, but we really have to get through this fight before Jekri takes any more stress damage if we can. Because I think you are guaranteed to die. Straight up, you have a heart attack and you cop it. I don't want to have to run away. Now, I'm assuming if you run away at this point, Jekri will not have said heart attack, but I'm still not that willing to try it. Oh, dodge! Do not want dodge! Yes. Great. 5, 3. It's not enough yet. Try this again. Yes. That's what we like to see. And then maybe D can actually try to stun this one. Give us one free turn on that. Thank you. So that's 8 there. That's dead. So now we will Noxious Blast. Right? 3 rounds, 2 rounds, yeah. So it's definitely got 8 rounds for 2 rounds. So that is completely dead. Maths is right, yeah? 16 is greater than 11? Pretty sure. You can't resist it once it's on you. Pretty sure. We now Noxious Blast. This one just does a lot of damage, and this one has like bleeds and debuffs. So I guess this one? Good. We could bleed out it. Crit chance 7% is not bad. It does bleed. Fuck it. Debuff yourself to all hell. Yes. You have trifled with the wrong people. Wicked hack. Sure. It may have been unnecessary because that thing would have died on the next round, but I'm feeling cocky, so... sorry, just whenever you say feeling cocky and then people go, oh, put your hands back on the table where I can see them. Just stun this. Stop it having another go. I don't need you to heal anybody. Well, you didn't heal, stun it, but that's okay. Why don't you not just blast this? Thank you for actually taking goes, by the way. This has been super useful for us. And that thing died before Jekri took any more stress damage, which is perfect. It's the graveyard slash. No, it's the monster slash. It was a graveyard bash. We've done it. That is the last battle. Bring it on.
This expedition at least promises success. Hmm.
There's no more, so I will take those. There's a curio here, which is a torch, which is nice. Gives that a little bit of extra not stressing out on the way. I'm hoping you take some stress relief just for succeeding, but I don't think you do. I mean, Jekri will be at a maximum of 100% when they get back. You know, the stuff over is not that bad. Torch up. Pack contains loot. Good. I don't want that. We're going to bring back quite a lot of stuff from this. And the fact that nobody's actually died is just inconceivable. Sweet as heck. Oh, seriously?
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted.
Yay!
Purpose is made clear.
You amazing person. Please be the last thing I have to do. Bring it on! No. Go home. Well, that turned around. The first thing we tried to do was obviously an epic failure. But that was our very, very first level 5 mission, and that was a complete success as far as I'm concerned. Which, it'd be going to be hard to argue against it. These people are level 6 now. Jekri is afflicted, but they have obviously gone back to 100% stress. So they didn't have a heart attack, which is exactly what we like to see. Everyone, what is wrong with you? Warren's Explorer is okay, but it has replaced Ruin's Adventurer, which is equivalent. Blight Resist, Quick Reflexes, +2 Speed. Replaced Wheeled Explorer, which is probably why we had... Oh, no, that was the... This is probably why we had so much scouting. Believes is possessed by demons. Well, okay. Unless max HP. That's probably bad for Jekri. It would be so bad for someone like D. Probably want to try and get rid of that. But let's see how much we ended up with. That was a good run, considering that we tried to do Sigiri's run.
The walls it didn't go to plan. World and that
I'll be quite honest.
Blonde,
you have lost the blooded fetish. Thin here. I think that was a good one. It was okay. I mean, I'm half expecting us to lose something that's amazing here, but okay. I guess that's only happens in the tavern, though. Maybe other things will cause you to lose stuff. I'm not entirely sure. Now, some people just gained an extra bit of stress heal. And of course, we put Holmesy and Erasmus back in, ready for the profit. But I'm very happy with that mission that we just undertook. We did just win something. So let's sort by this. We've got two of these. Do we need two of these? Probably not. We've got 13,000, which is not as much as I would have expected. If we sell this. We have got two of these, as noted. We've only got one abomination, so we might as well sell that. And get ourselves up to a fairly decent amount of money. Probably don't need two of these either. Yeah. I mean, I hardly use the one. Having several of these is often useful. What did we win from that actual expedition, though? I don't remember. Oh, it was this. More stun resist, more blight resist, more bleed resist, and less max HP. For the leper. Not too bad. Plenty of resistances that mean we don't have to deal with debuffs, basically. Seems decent, especially the stun resist. That's really good. Fine. I mean, I have no qualms with that. Very happy to have turned around a failed mission. Oh, we should put people in. Very happy to have turned around a failed mission and turned it into a, you know, an epic success in that respect. Jekri is going to obviously have to go in for gambling. That's expensive, but okay. That was one trinket you just cost me, but you got me way more money than that. So 21,000 is a decent amount to set people up, prepare for the profit mission, which we will do in the next episode, and, you know, hopefully actually get that thing dealt with because I'm tired of it. Vulnerability has 3. Perfect. Well, thank you for watching. I'm going to go through and just make sure the people who I'm taking are going to be taken. Why are you still in the transept? Excuse me. Excuse me, get out. You know what I was saying? Maybe. Wishes to remain in prayer. Okay, maybe we'll do something else. We shall see. But in the next episode, we shall do that. This has been an hour long. This is me signing off. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But until next time, good day.